So today's video is about using sound. Now that you know how to draw, we're going to talk about how to use sound, and then in your final lab for this module, you're going to combine the two to make a really creative sound and drawing expression. So when we start talking about sound, let's bring it up in Snap first, and then we're going to bring up an exterior page so that you can understand it a little bit better. I just brought up a blank Snap program, and I'm going to click on the sound button up here. And you'll note these ones are pink. They match the thing. Just like I said, they're all color-coded. We could drag one in here, it says play sound, and then it brings you a blank menu. If you had a sound uploaded, you could play it, but I've had some trouble with that working on my laptop, so I'm not going to focus on that. In fact, I think I'd rather talk about over here where we can actually play notes. So let's just real quick play one note so you can hear it, and then let's go talk about how to actually make real notes. So I'm going to play it at this tone so that it's very loud. So when I click on the flag, you should be able to hear it. Annoying, but you can hear it. So let's talk about how you figure out what notes equate to what. If you've ever learned an instrument or done any music, you've learned what notes are. And so you need to be able to convert this arbitrary number. It's not really arbitrary as it turns out, but it seems sort of arbitrary right now, to something that's actually a note. So I'm going to bring up Google, and I'm going to show you a web page that actually will have this. So you can see the URL on your screencast here. You can Google the same thing. Just Google for frequencies of musical notes. And this is a nice table. It actually gives you the frequencies here and the wavelengths. And this is not a physics class, so I'm not even going to explain the math. But it does give you the notes. So if you do know some music, you can actually convert the number here, like the play note 80, into an actual note. And you'll note that 80 is not actually a note. But if I move it to, say, 65.41, that will be a C. And you can put in those numbers. So that's C. So if you want to go play a song, you can use something like this table to actually convert your song into actual music. If you get this far and you drag in your play note and then it doesn't actually play, and you get an error that says, error, sound is not supported in this browser, it's another reason to look for a different browser. So that's one reason that I've stuck with Chrome. Firefox will run my programs, but Firefox, for some reason, won't play the sound. So you can do a bunch of things with this. You can change your tempo if you want. You can set your tempo to however many beats per minute that you want. You can rest. So I could just play a couple of notes. So let's play like the first three notes of Twinkle Twinkle. I don't know them off the top of my head. Even though I could sing it for you, I don't know the notes. So we're going to Google for it. Now I could have read the sheet music, but this will work just fine. C, C, G, G, A, A, G. Well, we already have one C in there, so let's play C, C, G, G. Let's go find the G. The G is 98. Go back to full screen mode, and we'll play C, C, G, G. I'm going to get rid of the tempo for the moment. But we do need to put a rest in there, because otherwise it sounds like one continuous note. So C, rest. And then C, rest. And then G, rest, G, rest. And now I just need to put in the notes. Okay, we click the flag and we should hear the first part of Twinkle Twinkle. When we click the flag, what happens? It sounds a little funny, but we're gonna live with it because this was just an example. There are lots of other ways that you can play with sound, and I invite you to go play with it and then get started on the exercise where you enable the user to be creative with their sounds.